The Defenders will see Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, and Iron Fist team up against a common enemy, the Hand. Now, we've seen the Hand before, and their plan has something to do with that seemingly bottomless pit at the Midland Circle construction site. A literal plot hole in season 2 of Daredevil. But could that pit actually be bottomless? Now, while Daredevil dropped a flashlight into that pit to hear when it hit the bottom, that's a trick which in reality wouldn't be all that useful.
There. Just hit. Gotta be 40 stories at least.
Remember, the Earth is spinning, which means that you and everything around you is traveling pretty damn fast. For instance, in New York, at a latitude of 40.7 degrees north, you're going some 1,300 kilometers an hour. But as you drop towards the core of the Earth, that horizontal velocity decreases. That's because it still takes the same amount of time for the Earth to spin around, but everything around you has less distance to travel. So drop 1 kilometer below the surface of the Earth and you start to edge towards that pit at some 5 or 6 centimeters a second. Another kilometer that doubles, and so on and so on. It's not going to be long before you hit the edge, but not necessarily the bottom. Of course, this isn't a problem if you dig your pit either at the North or South Pole, because then you're perfectly aligned with the rotational axis of the Earth. The next problem you might think of with a bottomless pit going through the world is the structure of Earth's interior. Now, we live on the crust. That's a layer of solid rock, some 35 kilometers deep on average, though depending where you are, it can be anywhere between 5 and 70 kilometers. But directly below that is the mantle. The rock there is so hot that while technically still a solid, it's very ductile and therefore able to flow over very long periods of time, which is a huge problem if you want to put a whopping great hole through it. Go below that and you're at the outer core, which now is a liquid, again, a very big problem. And then finally you reach the inner core, where the pressures are so high we think the iron there is actually solid, though we're not entirely sure. But actually, you don't need to worry about any of that, because it turns out you're not even going to reach the mantle in the first place. The question of how deep a hole you can dig is very similar to the question of how tall a mountain can be. It's just a balance of the material, namely rock's strength, against the weight of all of that material directly above it. This sort of simple calculation works out incredibly well and shows that Everest is about as tall a mountain as the Earth can support. But what does it say about a near bottomless pit? To answer this, we need to know a little bit about how gravity varies throughout the interior of the Earth. Now, assuming the Earth is a perfect sphere, Gauss's law for gravity tells us that we only need to consider the sphere of material directly below us. Anything above just cancels out. So if you were at the center of the Earth, because you're being equally pulled in all directions, gravity would be zero. And assuming the Earth has a constant density, as you venture away from that center, the force of gravity will increase, pulling you towards the center in a way that increases linearly with distance. Except the density of the Earth isn't constant. According to the preliminary reference Earth model, the strength of gravity throughout the crust and most of the mantle is almost constant. If anything, it goes slightly up. So how far can we drill down before the rock will start to crumble under its own weight? Well, the strongest parts of the crust, continental crust, are mostly made of granite, which has a compressive strength of 200 megapascals. That works out at about 23 kilometers before it starts to fail. But as I mentioned before with Game of Thrones, ice wall with such steep structures, it's not compressive stresses you have to worry about, but shear ones. And granite's shear strength is a mere 50 megapascals, limiting our bottomless pit to some 5.7 kilometers deep. And this math actually checks out, because the deepest mines in the world are only about 4 kilometers deep. So if you're planning on drilling a bottomless pit through the earth, perhaps to reach the other side in a swift 38 minutes by a gravity train, you're going to be sadly disappointed that your journey will be halted only a mere 0.05% of the way there. If I were you, I'd ask for a refund. I'd say you've got a pretty solid defense. Thank you so much for watching this video. I do hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you like it and let me know in the comments who your favorite defender is, and do subscribe to my channel for more physics content.